grandpa style. I'ma take your grandpa style. No, for real. Ask your grandpa, can I have his hand me down?
Thank you.
The Lord jumpsuit and some house slippers. Dookie Brown leather jacket that I found. Dig it.
Yeah, that song, Thrift Shop, was stuck in all of our heads about 2 years ago, and it made thrift shop shopping look cool, which for me, it's always been. But there's an art to it, and if you don't know the tricks, you're about to learn them. Stylist Lawrence Spivey of Sir Byron Laurent is here to show us how to find great style from thrift and consignment stores. Welcome back.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So, in general, and first of all, I have to say, you look incredible.
Thank you.
Everything you're wearing is from a thrift shop.
Everything I'm wearing today is completely from a thrift shop, from various thrift shops and consignment stores, but they're all from those types of stores.
Okay, so in general, what should a man be looking for when he walks into a thrift or a consignment store?
Well, one of the main things is to make sure that you're looking for classic items.
Okay.
Kind of stay away from trendy things. Especially, you know, things that are kind of odd colors or anything like that, unless you already built your wardrobe up. So, you know, stick with the very basics, two-button suits, very basic type of shirts.
Mm-hmm.
Those type of things, just the basics.
And look at the mannequin, very yes. sharp, and again, wearing those classic things that you mentioned.
Exactly.
And that, I love that pin, too. Is that from the thrift shop also?
That is from the thrift shop.
Wow.
This is a lapel pin, which is very popular right now
yeah.
in men's fashion. Came back popular again about
uh-huh.
2 years ago. And that's, once again, just an item that I found in a local thrift shop. Cost me about a dollar.
Uh-huh.
But if you go to, you know, any retail stores and get something brand new, it can be anywhere from $20 to $100.
And I love that you mixed different suit elements, because that vest obviously didn't come with that jacket.
Exactly.
But look at the way it comes together. It looks great.
Thank you. The biggest thing with this is you may go to a thrift store and you may find a blazer that you love, and
mm-hmm.
then you may find a trouser that you love, and you may find a vest that you love.
Yeah.
And it's just, you know, three separate things, but as long as they match or they coordinate, you just put it together and you still have a great outfit. So it's not about trying to find a whole outfit in a thrift
right.
store.
Does that jacket go with the pants you're wearing?
Actually, I think it is actually separate.
I mean, it looks like it could be a suit, but I mean, I'm just wowed by how trendy everything that you're wearing looks. And even the shoes that you brought
yes.
along with the mannequin look
you
great.
Grab those?
Yeah, just grab those.
So these shoes are actually shoes that I found at a local consignment store.
Uh-huh.
And they're actually Donald J. Pliner, which is a very high-end.
Yeah, I have one pair of Donald yeah. Pliners, and they cost me $800.
And these shoes actually for a while was actually still on their website. And they were going for about $200, and I only
wow.
ended up paying $15 for them.
That's incredible. Okay,
so.
We have a couple of models here who are sporting some great looks from consignment and thrift stores. Let's talk about the first one.
All right, so we're going to start with Darrell here in the vest and trouser set. This is actually a vintage suit that he has on, and there's actually a blazer to go with it. But we just separated it out because, of course, it's summertime and you want to try to be comfortable as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And so we just picked up a basic white dress shirt from
uh-huh.
A thrift store. His tie that he have there is a Jeffrey Bean, once again from a thrift store, cost about $1.19.
Wow.
And if we come down to his shoes, those are actually vintage.
Very nice.
Johnson & Murphy. Those are vintage
okay.
Johnson & Murphy. So. So that's the entire look. Very simple, and they cost actually less than $15.
For the shoes?
No, for the whole outfit.
For the whole outfit?
For the whole outfit.
Less than $15. Wow, he looks great. Okay, let's talk about the other model.
This model here is Graham, and he's actually wearing a gray outfit that's very simple, very basic, but it's comfortable, once again, with this weather. The blazer that he's wearing is actually from Bonobos, and if you're familiar with that company, you know, sell very nice clothing.
Uh-huh.
But it's very inexpensive, it was very inexpensive from a thrift store. We only paid $4 for it.
$4?
Exactly.
Wow, this is mind-blowing.
Once again, a white dress shirt. That dress shirt is actually from our very own Peter Millar from North Carolina,
okay.
high-end clothing company. Only paid a dollar for that. And then
this is outrageous.
Then
the seersucker.
Seersucker trousers on. So very simple from Old Navy. That or it's an Old Navy brand.
Mm-hmm.
Once again, that was only $2. And so we have this entire look, and it's a great look for. He's a college student at Winston-Salem State University.
Woo, woo, go Rams!
And a football
player. You did that
player.
Just for me.
I did
didn't
it for you.
You.
And a football player. So it's a great look for him to wear, you know, if he's getting interviewed or anything like that. And, I mean, the whole look, once again, the pocket square was thrifted as well for 25 cents.
Very nice. These were awesome looks. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Up next on My Carolina Today, some safety things to think about. Oh, I forgot. Got to tell you about Lawrence's class. Dress for Success for Less at Wake Tech, June 10th through July 15th. Get details at waketech.edu.